A reheating furnace is considered the heart of a rolling mill. Typically, top-fired pusher-type reheating furnaces are used in steel re-rolling mill units to heat the raw material, that is, ingots, billets, or scraps, to 1200 degrees Celsius temperature. The furnace is fired with a variety of fuels like lump coal, pulverized coal, furnace oil, natural gas, coal-based producer gas, etc. An optimum design of the furnace is important for higher productivity at the lowest cost. A conventional furnace is not based on engineering design. Usually, such furnaces are used as mere heating chambers. The furnace walls are at an excessively high temperature with flames gushing out of the openings. The furnace does not have a waste heat recovery system, so large quantity of heat is wasted into the atmosphere. The furnaces are equipped with a long preheating zone, but a heating zone is almost never present. Heavy firing is done through the furnace front burners, which often lead to high scale formation and energy consumption. Refractories in these types of furnaces are regularly replaced. Overall, the furnace performs at an efficiency level below 25%. Designing of an energy-efficient furnace starts with determining the correct length of the furnace. The effective length of the furnace, that is, the length of the furnace from the discharge door center to the flue gas outlet center, is the one that takes part in the combustion. Hearth area productivity for an energy-efficient, top-fired pusher-type furnace should be more than 275 kg per meter square per hour. The total effective length of the furnace should be equally distributed into three zones, namely soaking zone, heating zone, and preheating zone. The furnace is built with refractories and insulation bricks mounted in a steel structure. The next step is to determine the total heat required in the furnace. The required number of burners, as per design, may be determined. 70% of the total heat input should be in the heating zone and the balance, 30%, in the soaking zone. Piping and combustion design come next. Piping should be so designed as to maintain equal fuel and air pressure at all burner tips. The foundation of the furnace should be steady. Now, when the furnace is ready, the following should be added to make it energy efficient. High efficient metallic recuperator at a flue gas outlet. Furnace monitoring devices like thermocouples, pressure gauge, oxygen analyzer. Furnace automation and control system. All hot air pipelines to be insulated. Covers for furnace openings. So, an energy-efficient furnace to ensure optimum productivity at the least cost is ready. An engineering-designed, energy-efficient reheating furnace will cost at least three times more than a conventional furnace of similar capacity. However, the following benefits can be achieved by the energy-efficient furnace. Reduced specific fuel consumption by 25 to 30%. Higher productivity by 5 to 10%. Reduced burning loss by 20 to 25%. Increased life of refractory and insulation. Savings in terms of greenhouse gases. The investment made for an energy-efficient furnace can be recovered within maximum 15 months.